Good evening, I'm Nicholas Hoare. Yale University Press is famous for its Catholic taste in literature. One never knows from one month to the next what it's going to publish next. And the joy in handling some of their products is simply not to be overestimated. One of the latest and most enjoyable of their productions is a book by the legendary John Sutherland, who is, of his type, the best short essay writer on literary matters going. His counterpart, late lamented John Leonard in New York, might have been accused of being much the same. The two were cut from the same cloth. But John Sutherland, from the British vantage point, has the additional plus of a very wicked sense of humor. In the latest work that he's produced, which is a magnum opus called Lives of a Novelist, he has taken the lives of 290-odd writers, ranging from Booth, Tarkington, to, of all people, Max Brand, and potted their stories in two or three pages apiece. The result is you don't have to plow through a 300-page piece to master the story of Kingsley Amis. You do it in a couple of pages. And speaking of Kingsley Amis, this is an example of what he has to say. Kingsley's career as a novelist and increasingly acerbic commentator on various aspects of Englishness is exhaustively chronicled. But one aspect of his life invites further investigation for the effect it had on its fiction. Boozer could have been chiselled on Amis's gravestone, not that posterity needed any reminder that he was, above all else, a laureate of the bottle. In 2010, Everyday Drinking, which was first published in 1983, was re-released to nostalgically warm reviews. It gathered pieces originally written for The Telegraph in 1972, a period when Philip Larkin was writing for the same paper on jazz, subjects they had both applied themselves to at Oxford while effortlessly scooping up their firsts. Alcohol plays a pivotal role in the opening and closing sections of Lucky Jim. In the first comic set piece, A High Cultural Weekend at the Country House of Professor Welch, and so on and so forth. This is an extraordinarily entertaining book, and it's not the sort of thing one tackles on a block, obviously, but to have it on your bedside table and to dabble away an author at a time is to enjoy a series of bedtime chuckles that are extremely hard to beat. And I would recommend this handsome tome, Lives of the Novelists, very warmly indeed. I would also congratulate John Sutherland on, from my point of view anyway, his magnum opus, and I would commend it highly. And on that literary note, good night.